Welcome, everybody. It's open mic night live at the ZoomBarDC. We've got a great night for you tonight. We've got an awesome lineup. We've got Ed Crowley, Dave Sherman, Memphis Gold, Ardamus, Braden Eddy, Tom Mann, Reggie Stout, and Warren Hayford, Blake Wilson, and more people. So sit back, enjoy the music, put on your dancing shoes, and have a good time. And we are going to kick off tonight with Ardamus.
Where's the post of the Facebook Live? Under what? Because I'm here.
Go to my timeline.
Oh, go to your timeline. Okay, I'll refresh. Go ahead. Okay. Great. Terrific. Okay. Starting now.
Yo. How y'all doing, man? Happy New Year to everybody. I haven't seen anybody in a minute, so it's good to see everybody. Hold up, before I even begin, I'm gonna make sure y'all can hear me first. Hold on a second. Y'all can hear that, right?
Oh yeah.
Cool. All right. So let's get to this. I've done this one before. It's called Lifeline. Love to love you, love you not. Love to love you, love you not. Love to love you, love you not. Love to love you. Pretty, pretty smile. Sit me down, up and then get me down. My mind, travel to a new place in the morning. See a new face, hey. Touch on your past, ice breaking. Crush with the glass, no. Cause new hurting, old school, trying to rule the new earth. I know that you've been lying. You ain't gotta say much to me, keep on denying. You ain't gotta play tough. I'm not a project objective to see these prospects give all of the own. So for you to own, judge by the paint, court to zone. Minimize on a spent line at an angle, going to incline, done increments, hand behind the back, fight ignorance. I know that you've been lying. You ain't gotta say much to me, keep on denying. You ain't gotta play tough. Love to love you, love you not. Love to love you, love you not. Love to love you, love you not. Love to love you, love to love you. A little something.
All right.
A little something.
Yeah.
I enjoy doing that song. I don't do enough songs on like 3-4.
Yeah, so. Man, I dig that one.
Yeah, thank you.
That's a good groove.
Thank you.
You know what, the with the blue light, it looked, feel like I'm watching a music video.
Yeah, no, that was it's it. I mean, I got this LED, so, and yeah. These new pictures too in the back. So I'm gonna put some more up to kind of give it this feel. You know?
Can you like change the color?
You want me to change the color? I was like, yeah, sure.
Let's see if you can do it.
Yeah.
Like, what if you like only change the color during the chorus or something like that?
I did that before. I've done that before. Like, I changed it up during songs too. But
nice.
Actually, I'm gonna keep it on this one for this one.
Okay.
It's great.
Thank you. You gotta let me go, baby girl, you gotta let me go. I'm talking to you, it's true, you gotta let me go. Baby girl, you gotta let me go. Yeah. You gotta let me go, baby girl, you gotta let me go. I'm talking to you, it's true, you gotta let me go. Baby girl, you gotta let me go. Not one for mistakes, running around. Got prey on the run and I'm hunting them down. And it's all over town, it's all over my face. Left you behind, I was on the chase. Call me when I am, champion boss. Till the snapping ain't shut and you're in for a loss. You gotta hate or do love. Hear what you breathe, know what you think, can't hear what you need. Fall back on the truth, know you as well. Got horns in the horn, and you know what's hell. You ain't saying too much, sealing the dot. Ain't gonna grow, not healing the cross. Front lines with the news, you can spread with the fate. You can take it all in. Left for the pain, I ain't fooling around. Enough of the cause, run for myself, you ain't tough on your flaws. Yeah. You gotta let me go, baby girl, you gotta let me go. I'm talking to you, it's true, you gotta let me go. Baby girl, you gotta let me go. Yeah. You gotta let me go, baby girl, you gotta let me go. I'm talking to you, it's true, you gotta let me go. Baby girl, you gotta let me go. What is not is what is meant to me. I got some enemies and friends to meet. And what is not is what is meant to be. I got some friends to meet. I forgot the rest of that. Damn it. Anyways, thank you. I just wanted to do a short set for a second, y'all. Okay. I ain't seen y'all in a minute, too, and I was feeling a little rusty. So.
Awesome.
Yeah, man.
I have more. I have newer stuff, but it's just like memorizing it takes a lot, you know?
Yeah, I love your classics, Ardamus, so don't worry about coming. Just come back with your old stuff. I love your old stuff.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Sure. Okay. So, let's see.
I'll go ahead.
Warren, do you want to go next?
Yeah. Can everybody hear this all right? Volume are okay?
Yep.
Yeah, cool.
Sounds great.
All right, this one's kind of a topical jazz song that I wrote this week. It's called Running in the Streets.
The last lyric till we give him what?
A war.
So
the only good fascist is a dead fascist.
I go along with that.
That was Woody Guthrie's guitar, right? This is right. Machine kills fascists.
That's right.
That's right.
Yeah. This is a song I wrote. Hold on a second, gotta remember the name to it. Will Rivers Outrun Wildfires is the name of this song.
heroes on some high lonesome plane, smoking their sorrows and choking down pain, singing their songs to the stars as their veins pump full with the force of a fierce Texas rain. Days they run together, nothing changing but the weather, while the nightly gales still sing the same old song of devil's deeds and poet's dreams. Nothing here is what it seems. We live the tales of those long dead and gone. And to what do I owe this fine surprise? How I long to see your loving eyes, calling me back from that place where the sun stops to rest. Four horsemen stand at their bishop's command, watch as the pawns pour their blood on the sand. When the queen's had her fill, there'll be nothing left to kill. For now it's best to focus on the orders at hand. With rivers out on wildfires, chasing dreams and dark desires, till they meet up on the other side. The echo across the barren wastes, freedom calls, hurry haste, it fills our righteous sails with foolish pride. And now what do I make of all these lives? Shivering rod for my eyes, calling me out to that place where the sun stops to rest. Itself again, my friend, and I wonder, will it ever come to end? All the stories that inspire us all pretend.
You're on mute. You want to,
Am I on mute now?
We can hear you now. Are you ready to go?
I'm ready to go. If y'all ready to go.
We're ready when you're ready. Let's go.
Can you see me pretty good?
Yep, we can see you.
All right. Well, this first song I want to send out to all the people who didn't make it out of the riots this weekend, this past weekend. It was crazy. And I want to send this out to them. I'm going to start my, if I can, I'm going to start my little band members here together. All righty.
Nice work.
Thank you. Thank great. You so very, very much. You know, man, I tell you, I'll be so glad when I can play back out again, man. It's crazy. You know, I'm going to the studio, though, to do some recording tomorrow. I'll be in Q Studio, so I'm looking forward to being there tomorrow. Early in the morning, around 10 o'clock, I'm going to be doing some recording with Blaine and Ken, those guys. So I'm going to be at the Falls Church. But anyway, there's a song, if you can give me a minute, that I like to do. One song that way back down south, back in, one of my uncles taught me this song, I guess way back in the day, called, oh my God. You know, guys, you'll know when you hear it. All right, guys.
Oh, yeah. It's a testament to your skill that it was hard to tell what was the backing track and what was you, but it was clear when your lead was going. Let me just ask you this. Did you create the backing track? Or you?
Yeah, I created the backing track, man. Oh my God. Yes, I did.
So you created it all. You're basically multiple tracking like the Beatles in 1960s.
Exactly. But the drum part, then the bass, you know, doing the bass. I had to figure it out because it's a pretty cool instrument. It's called a trio band looper, you know what I'm saying? And it's got little different things. You have to kind of think about it for a minute, you know what I'm telling you? But it kind of comes together, you know? It takes an old man like me all week to do it, though, you know?
Right. So I think I may be the only person you know who may have said this phrase. I think you're acting like Sir George Martin.
Oh, really?
The producer of the Beatles. The phrase Memphis Gold and Sir George Martin, I don't think has been in a sentence, but I thought I'd offer it up to you.
Thank you.
Hey, Memphis.
Thank you.
Hey, Memphis.
Yo.
Do you play St. James Infirmary? You know that song?
Yeah, I know the song. Yeah,
right on. That'll be a really cool one to hear one of these nights if you feel like playing it.
I sure would. I'd be great. I would love to do it one night, man. All right. Thank you.
That New Orleans stuff.
Love you guys.
Oh, it's awesome. Thank you so much. Oh,
thank you so much for having me.
Let's see. Blake Wilson, do you want to go next?
Yeah, sure. You can hear me all right?
Yep.
Okay. I think the guitar is a little harder than it looks. I'm actually going to attempt it. I got like a couple chords now. All right. That is not it. There we go.
What do you normally play?
I've just started playing like a week ago.
Oh,
if I can't do it, I'm just gonna switch to acapella. Remember everything. What have I become, my sweetest friend? Everyone I know goes away in the end, and you could have it all, my empire of dirt. I will let you down, I will make you hurt. I wear this crown of thorns upon my liar's chair, full of broken thoughts I cannot repair. Beneath the stains of time, the feelings disappear. You are someone else, I am still right here. What have I become, my sweetest friend? Everyone I know goes away in the end, and you could have it all, my empire of dirt. I will let you down, I will make you hurt. Yeah, as I said, the guitar is harder than it looks.
Hey, that's a great song, man. That's a tough one to start with on guitar.
It's three chords.
Beautiful. I really like that. Thank you.
Good. I'm unclear. I haven't gone to as many. Do you play any instrument? Are you normally a lead singer or what?
Please. I sing a cappella for some reason. Like.
Oh, okay.
I could not sing to accompaniment, so I thought the only way I could figure out how to sing to accompaniment is to learn an instrument.
Oh, so you've tried, kind of backing, instrumental backing.
Yeah,
backing,
yeah.
And that doesn't work for you. Okay.
Well, it sounded beautiful, Blake. Keep it up.
Yeah, you got a good ear, man. You got a good ear, bro. You got a good ear, man. I'm telling you, without playing a guitar, you got a good ear. I'm telling you.
Yeah, no more attempt on the guitar, for sure, man.
Yeah.
Acapella can be so beautiful. I mean, it's really, it's just, when someone cannot do acapella, it makes such a huge impression. If you notice a lot of great artists with musicians and bands and stuff, the moment that they do in their encore, it's the acapella or an ending number.
Yeah.
It's often the showstopper where you can't hear a pin drop because the person is killing it. So.
Well,
you can kill it all the time.
When I'm practicing, I don't actually play the chorus because it has an F chord in it, and there's just no way.
you ain't hit no bad notes, man. I tell you, you don't hit no bad notes at all. That's good.
Ever play around with an auto harp, Blake?
I'm not actually convinced an F chord's possible. I'm sorry. What was the question again?
You ever try out an auto harp?
No, I haven't.
Because you can just, it has buttons that are labeled with the chords on them, and all you got to do is strum the strings, and it mutes the ones that aren't in the chord, so you can just,
That's a good idea.
Accompaniment.
Blake, are you going to play another song?
No, I'm not.
Okay. Okay. Well, thank you. That was great. Keep it, keep doing it.
Well, does anyone recall the name of the version he did is the Johnny Cash version of the Nine Inch Nails Trent Reznor. And I've always wanted to know who is the what's the name of that producer who basically, I'd love to have been in the room the first time that producer played Trent Reznor for Johnny Cash. And Johnny Cash goes, great, let's do it. I mean, because his version is extraordinary, but it comes from a guy known for kind of a heavy metal-ish Nine Inch Razor stuff sound. So that's what's so great about it.
Yeah. Okay. So let's see. Braden, do you want to go next?
Yeah, I can go next. This first song I'm going to do is called Sleeping Sickness by a European band called City in Color.
Thank you. I awoke, lonely to find my lungs empty. And through the night, it seems that I am not free. And then, now my dreams are nothing like they were meant to be. And I'm breaking down. I think I'm breaking down. And I'm afraid to sleep because of what haunts me, such as living with the uncertainty that I'll never find the words to say, which would completely explain just how I'm breaking down. Someone's coming, someone's coming to save my life. Maybe I'll sleep when I am dead, but now it's like the night is taking aside. All the worries that occupy the back of my mind. Could it be this misery will survive? I become a simple souvenir of someone's kill. And like the sea, the seeds that I intend to talk to will. And the madness fills my heart and soul, which the great divide would swallow me whole. Is how I'm breaking down. Someone's coming, someone's coming to save my life. Maybe I'll sleep when I am dead, but now it's like the night is taking a silence. All the worries that occupy the back of my mind. Could it be this misery will survive? And could it be this misery will survive?
That was very good. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I don't know why I'm echoing.
Yeah, it's a song that just kind of been sitting with me all week with everything going on. The next one I'm going to do, another cover this evening. It's kind of been one of my guilty pleasures that I've always played by myself but never done in front of other people. So we're going to give this a shot.
It's all the same, lonely the names have changed. And every day it feels I'm wasting away. Another place, the faces are so cold. I drive all night to get back home. I'm a cat boy, on a steel horse I ride. I'm wanted, dead or alive. I'm wanted, dead or alive. Sometimes I sleep, sometimes gates, the people I meet go their separate ways. Sometimes you tell the day, the bottle that you drink. Sometimes you're all alone, and all you do is think, is I'm a cowboy, and a steel horse I ride. I'm wanted, dead or alive. I'm wanted, dead or alive. I walk these streets, the six string on my back, and I play for keeps, 'cause I might not make it back. Been everywhere, still I'm standing tall. I've seen a million faces, and I rocked them all. 'Cause I'm a cowboy, and a steel horse I ride. I'm walking dead or alive. I'm
You're not actually in public.
Because I've probably played it a million times just sitting here by myself thinking, does anybody else want to hear Bon Jovi too, or is it just me?
I guess here's the thing you have with me. I don't know the song. It's not like Stairway to Heaven for me. It's not a cliche to me. So I don't know the song that well.
That's a great cover for you, Brady.
Thank you very much.
Awesome, thanks.
You think your Facebook page is live at the...
if you're listening on Facebook, you have to mute the Facebook audio, otherwise there's a big echo.
Yeah.
So,
Arthur, you're the source of the echo there.
So I had to mute you, Art, because there was an echo from your stream there, but I think the Facebook thing might be live public right now, I hope.
Yeah, you got
it. So I changed one of the settings. Okay, Tom Mann, are you out there? Do you want to tell a story?
Sure.
Yay!
So I just put it together while we're sitting here that all the stuff last week happened in your zip code or area code. I hope you're all okay and not too traumatized. I live alone in the desert where all of this was happening on the other side of the moon. but I don't want to take undue credit, but I saw this coming 25 years ago. I'd been doing public relations in Silicon Valley for about 10 or 15 years in the early 90s. And suddenly everybody's talking about the information superhighway. Don't be roadkill on the information superhighway, or as Gore called it, the national information infrastructure. And I knew it was something I was going to have to pay attention to, because one day I got a call from a publishing house in Berkeley called Osmo McGraw-Hill. You may have heard of them. And they said, we'd like you to come in and pitch our public relations. I said, I'm happy to do that. Can you send me an information package so I can look and see what you do? And they said, well, just check our website. And I thought, yeah, right. Huh. The next day I got a call from a software company in Alameda, getting the same thing. We'd like you to come in and pitch our business. Can you send me an information package? That's all at our website. Well, you know, it's kind of like Alice's restaurant. If you hear something once, it's a data point. When you hear it twice, you should probably pay attention. if you hear something three times in 3 days, it's a goddamn movement. So I started paying attention. And because I'd been doing public relations for a long time in the Bay Area, my name was on lists of PR professionals. And so I got calls from some of them, especially the ones who were starting up in the South of Market area in San Francisco, that soon after came to be called the dot-com universe. And my first thing about the internet was, I thought this was the biggest gift from God. I mean, as a writer, to be able to have infinite, or to have instant access to infinite information, what more could you want? You don't even have to get out of your pajamas and slippers, and you can have access to the Vatican Library, the Louvre, CIA, anything you want. And how great could that be? So I saw this as the greatest gift to philosophers like myself that had ever come around. But so I got an invitation to come and pitch some of these businesses. And I would usually ask questions like, well, what's your marketing strategy? What is it you're trying to achieve? Who do you want to reach? And they said, we want to secure stinky highballs. And I said, stinky highballs? What would a stinky highball be? And they kept talking about how stinky highballs were going to be the future. And first of all, I was in my mid-40s then, and most of these guys were around maybe 20, 22. And I'd never been in a serious business where people played, you know, board hockey games and threw footballs around. It just wasn't what you saw in Fortune 50 companies. Well, I come to find out that they weren't talking about stinky highballs. They were talking about sticky eyeballs, which didn't make any more sense to me than the other. And I asked them to explain to me what a sticky eyeball was. And they said, we want to keep people who come to our site to stay there. And I said, why? I mean, Time Magazine doesn't care what you do with their magazine once you buy it, pay for it. You can read it for 2 minutes or 2 hours. It's immaterial. They said, no, you don't understand. We want to score high on our SEO. And I said, what's an SEO? They said, well, it's search engine optimization. I said, what the hell are you talking about? They said, we want to keep people at our site. And I said, well, no intelligent person is going to stay on your site. What are they staying for? And they said, well, that's it. We don't expect to get intelligent people. We're trying to get dumb people. Or if they're already smart, we try to make them dumb. And that a light went on then, and I realized that's the business model. You take intelligence, you got this technology that can make the whole world smart, and we're going to make people dumb. I thought, I got to see that. Well, I saw it last week. It's really not hard to do if you just keep telling people how smart they are and feed them a load of crap. They're going to start to believe that they have truth. Reminded me of something old man Thomas Edison once said. I built the greatest educational tool in the history of the world, the radio. And all they do is use it to sell soap. I'm disappointed. And I think Tim Berners-Lee, the guy that created the internet algorithm, the internet protocol, he's feeling the same way because he's working on something to make his first www.1.0 to put it to sleep and come up with World Wide Web 2.0. And just yesterday, to my surprise, I was invited to join a standards group at the Institute of Electrical and Electronic Engineers. This is a global consortium of real engineers. And this is a working group to come up with something better than what we got. And the web came on so strong, so fast, nobody thought to put limits on it. So Google and Facebook and the others got in and they set the rules. And the rules are anything you post, we own. And we're finding out now that was a big mistake. So Web 2.0 is going to be where you own your own information and you choose what you want to give to somebody. So I'm really excited about looking forward to that, especially since the beginning of the web, when everybody else was so jazzed about it, I was thinking, careful. there's a lot of sand traps here, and now they're showing up. But I hope that groups like the IDA Triple E can help correct it before it's too late. Anyway, that's Tom's Adventures in Internet Land.
Thank you, Tom. That gives us a lot of insight.
I posted an article I did at a meeting, Tom, where I did a lot of roundup of stuff, a lot of it related to web-related creation of stupidity and extremism. So it's, I posted in the chat. But thanks so much. You were there on the ground.
Yes.
That was awesome. Great story, Tom. Thank you.
Thank you, man.
Thank you. Yeah, I can't believe it. In only 25 years, the internet went from a novelty to being the central nervous system of the human race. And it's owned basically by two guys who each have made $185 billion off of it, Zuckerberg and Bezos. That can't last.
And then there's Google and YouTube, too. YouTube in particular has been a radicalizing force and have this algorithm, you know. So I wish this good stuff like we're putting out here and you're doing could get in YouTube algorithms and people follow that to roots music and good stuff as opposed to following bad stuff. So thanks for all you're all doing.
It's insane. That's what the music industry has gone to as well. It's just, internet, creating an internet, as they're saying, sticky eyeballs. That's the whole idea instead of selling it albums anymore. It's kind of nuts.
Yeah. Social media that makes people less social and more lonely. Yeah, it's crazy. So
I have a solution.
Here we are.
Go out and hear live music.
Yep. Yeah. When is that going to?
That's right.
Well, they changed the, they changed the vaccine rules today. So if you're over 65, in theory, you can go out and get a vaccine. Let me explain something.
Wait, Art, tell us later, okay?
Okay, I thought it was funny. I was gonna tell you.
Okay, tell us later.
Okay, bye.
Dave, you wanna go next?
Sure. I actually have a new one.
Yay.
That I've never done before. I just learned it yesterday. Lazy Lester tune. Lazy Lester passed away last year, but he left us a lot of good tunes, so. I hear you knocking, I hear you calling, I hear you every time you say my name. But it's no use, baby, your calling's all in vain. No use in crying, no use in lying. You tried to cheat, baby, you're to blame. But it's no use, baby, your calling's all in vain. I packed my suitcase, I packed my ticket, I won't be long and I'll be on my way. 'Cause I'm leaving, yes, I'm leaving, and I'm going away to stay. I hear you knocking, I hear you calling, I hear you every time you say my name. But it's no use, baby, your calling's all in vain. I packed my suitcase, I bought my ticket, it won't be long and I'll be on my way. 'Cause I'm leaving, yes I'm leaving, and I'm gone away to you stay. I hear you knocking, I hear you calling, I hear you every time you say my name. But it's no use, baby, your calling's all in vain.
Very nice, Bob.
Thank you. Wait till I learn it. I don't have to read it. And we can do a little Slim Harpo.
Yay!
Tell you about a Dan that's going around. Everybody's doing it, from the grown-ups down. Don't move your head, don't move your hands, don't move your lips, just shake your hips. Do the hip shake, babe. Do the hip shake, babe. Do the hip shake, babe. Shake your hips, baby. What you don't know, don't be afraid. Just listen to me and do what I say. Don't move your head, don't move your hand, don't move your lips, just shake your hips. Do the hip shake, babe. Do the hip shake. Do the hip shake, baby. Shake your hips, babe. Country town. She said, what do you know? There's Slim Harpo. Didn't move her head, didn't move her hand, didn't move her lips, just shake her hips. Do the hip shake, baby. Do the hip shake, baby. Hip shake, baby. Shake your hips, baby.
Come on, Pop. My hips are shaking.
As those of you might have seen my head bobbing, that was fantastic.
Thank you. He couldn't keep his head
Thank
still.
Very much.
He shook his head. He should not have shook his head.
Yep. Just shake your hips.
He didn't follow the rules. So, he wasn't listening. You weren't listening, Art.
I wasn't listening?
No, you're supposed to just shake your hips, not shake your head.
Well, I was in the middle of doing stuff on my keyboard, so I couldn't get up and dance at the time. First
Thanks,
time
Dave.
I heard that was
awesome.
Thing. Thank you, Marie.
Main Street. Okay, Reggie, do you want to go next?
Sure. So I hate to break, but we're grooving here. I don't. I'm having second thoughts about doing something. I was gonna try. Let's start out with some bluesy thing that's got a little rhythm to it. Anyway. So So G.L. Crockett's part of that swamp. So I'll do my old G.L. Crockett thing. That's kind of bassy, isn't it? Let's see.
One of my favorite blues songs from like when I was a teenager.
Yeah, well, that's what I heard. My brother played it when I was a kid.
Yeah. Who wrote it and sang it originally?
Well, G.L. Crockett does that version. That's kind of a stolen from Elmore James, One Way Out, but it's that's the version that was done in the
50s. And the name of the song again?
It's A Man Down There.
Oh wow, never heard that.
And there's a it's a little loud. I just found out from Bob Melardi, the bass player with a bunch of people, but he does that song. He's the only person I ever heard do that song live, but he told me there's an answer song to it. I'm the Man Down There. I got to find out when I learn it.
Yeah, Anson.
Yeah. So, yeah. So now, to mess up the mood here, I'm going to try something, an old song that I really love that... not quite so upbeat. This is that stuff they called No Depression. When was it, in the 90s, I think, maybe?
Yeah, that right. That was an all, and then they created a magazine off it. That, but No Depression was a was an early alt Americana group, right?
Right, right. Yeah, yeah. Okay, Uncle Tupelo split into Wilco and Sunvolt, and everybody loved Wilco, but I love Sunvolt. So.
Me too.
This is from their album. It's called Tear Stained Eye. I don't know. I've never tried to play this before, so we'll see. Walking down Main Street. Getting to know the concrete, looking for answers in a neon sign. I would meet you anywhere, the western sun meets the air. We hit the road, never looking behind. Can you deny? There's nothing greater, nothing more than the traveling hands of time. St. Genevieve can hold back the water, but the saints don't bother with the tear-stained eye. Watching the traces of the stars that came before, hitting the pavement and coming back for more. I can mail shoot. Well, we're good. Okay, yeah, I didn't get through it, did I? Okay. And the best line, too, that I messed up. Yeah. When the hours don't move along, worn out wood and forgotten songs. To hear your voice is not enough, and it's more than a shame. Or can you deny there's nothing greater, nothing more than the traveling hands of time? St. Genevieve can hold back the water, saints don't bother with the tear-stained eye. Like a man said, rode hard, put away wet, throw out the bad news, give it a rest. Every living is learning, and the truth is a state of mind. Oh, it'll get better at the end of the line. Oh, can you deny there's nothing greater, nothing more than the traveling hands of time? St. Genevieve can hold back the water, but the saints don't bother with the tear-stained eye. St. Genevieve can hold back the water, but the saints don't bother with a tear-stained eye.
Well, that was magnificent.
Great song. Too bad. Yeah, man.
That is from the Sunvolt, The Breakaway.
That's the Trace album. Trace is the name of the album.
And who was that lead singer for Sunvolt?
I forgot his
whatever name. It's fantastic.
Yeah.
The other group around that time was Whiskey Town.
Yeah. I have some of their stuff. They had some.
And then he went on to become a jerk, but early in Whiskey Town was great, and all that early stuff you're drawing from is great. So it wasn't only. I've got to tell you, I listen to a lot of Americana, love it, know it. That is the best Americana song I've heard in years.
Oh yeah, no.
The fact that you spotted it puts you in an Emmy Lou Harris song picking category. That is a phenomenal song.
Well, yeah,
fantastically.
About all that.
That's my view. It's great.
Oh, yeah. But Johnny Cash picked Hurt, so he wins.
Yeah, but song
picking. Thanks, Reggie. Thanks, Reggie. That was great.
Thanks,
thank you. Okay, Ed, are you gonna close us out? Take us out.
I will, because everybody will tune out after I play. I'm quite sure about that. I'm gonna do a Delbert McClinton song.
Hi.
And it's a love song. It's really a very sweet song, but I recognize that it certainly also is appropriate for our friends on the right side of the aisle too. I just was thinking about it from that perspective, and it kind of works. It's called "Don't Want to Love You Anymore." I don't know who they would be talking about, but I'm just saying. Don't want to love you anymore. If I could, I'd close that door. It's not the way it was, and it hurts me way too much. Don't want to love you anymore. Don't want to love you anymore. It's uncertain, that's for sure. It's time to face the fact that you don't love me back. Don't want to love you anymore. I don't want to need you like I need you tonight. Don't want to want you and live this kind of life. You give me just enough of what I need to keep me hanging on. Don't want to love you anymore. Don't want to love you anymore. Don't want to fight a losing war. No need to try again. There's no way I can win. Don't want to love you anymore. Don't want to love you anymore.
Well, thank you.
So today I was thinking, what would be a song that there's no way in God's creation that this has ever been done on the ukulele? That's how my mind works. Since I'm learning the instrument, I figured I would learn songs that would never thought of to be on the ukulele. So I thought of the band Traffic. I thought Traffic. I'm sure that Steve Winwood never did anything on a ukulele. So this song's called Light Up and Leave Me Alone, which was like the theme song of my undergraduate years.
Right.
It was just, I wore this album out. Low Spark of the High Heel Boys, I think, was the name of the album. Sometimes I feel like I'm fading away. You're looking at me, I got nothing to say. Don't make me angry with the games that you play. Either light up or leave me alone. Leave me alone. You walk in my room, you lie on my bed. You open your mouth, shoot someone dead. All of a sudden you're inside my head. Either light up or leave me alone. Trying to tell me about the birds and the bees, spending my bread like it grew on a tree. The skirt you're wearing is way past your knees. Either light up or leave me alone. Up all night preaching on your mind. Come home in the morning with your latest find. I'm gonna have to lay it to you straight on the line. Either line up or leave me alone. Yeah, leave me alone. You gotta leave me alone. Baby, light up or leave me. You gotta leave me alone.
Haven't heard that in years. Big tune.
That's probably a good thing. You haven't heard that one.
Oh, no.
Thank goodness.
Oh, no. Haven't heard it, ukulele or otherwise, in a long, long time. Nice.
Thank you.
Love that.
Thanks, Ed. That was awesome.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Okay. Well, that's our show. So thanks, everybody. Thanks, Ed. Thanks, Reggie. Thanks, Tom. Thanks, Braden. Thanks, Juan.
You.
Thanks, Dave.
Thank you.
Thank you, thanks, everybody.
Blake. Thanks, everybody.
Thanks so much.
Thanks for hosting, Marie.
Thank
You're
you.
Welcome. Thanks. See you next week.
All righty. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Stay safe and well.
Thanks, Tom.